feature video series. I would like to talk about the creation of counters. This is mainly useful in case of folding battens, where the crease channels should look much better than conventional creasing. I'm going to start this creation with RPO scan, because that is the major starting point for creation of the files. Let's zoom in. So I just run a new standard. Okay, in this case I am going to use AutoLock style. I choose the right paper for this and I enter a value for it. This done, the file is ready. Within RPO scan, there is an option to output the matrix. So you can see that it exports both the cutting file as well as the matrix file. Now when you go to the preview of this, you can actually see how the matrix is formed. Now some of the customers may want their matrix files matrix to be thicker. So in that case, what I can do is change the pointage of the crease lines to a thicker pointage, after which you could see that the channels have become wider. So I'm going to make a counter, design 10C, C standing for counter. Now I would also export the sample file, design 10, and create the counter. So the counter is created. The cutting file is also created. Now additionally, I could also add some plain rectangle cut marks, cuts here, windows. This is for the purpose of having better vacuum hold down of the cutting sheet. As a next step, I move on to iCut production console, where I open and configure the cutting file as well as the counter file. You can see here that this is the counter file. So these are the matrix and these are the window cuts, which will allow for better vacuum hold down. This one is the original cutting file. Next step is the cutting of the counter and the actual file. So what I do is, we have the ruler kit using which I can align the counter file. Once this is aligned, I just run the job. I'm using a standard static knife tool. Can you see it? You can see now it is cutting the matrix. As a next stage, it is cutting out the windows.
you actually see this one, it's a matrix file. What I could do is use thin blades to weed the counter channels. So this one is a matrix file. As a next step, I realign counter, and then I take a fresh sheet. This is the sheet on which the actual sample is going to be cut. Make sure the alignment of both the sheets, they are of same size, is perfect. So once this is done, switch on the vacuum to make sure they don't move. Now if you focus on here, you could actually see why I had cut these windows. It is because through the windows, the top sheet is held firmly. Moving on, here within IPC, what I do is bring the original file. Now if you notice, I make one change. The change here is, instead of through cutting, I give a certain depth to make sure it leaves the counter material uncut and just cuts the original sheet. So configuration is done, I just run the file. Notice here,
fast.
You can notice here that the channels are formed, the crease channels, as like a die cutting output. So that is cutting of a folding carton sample with the counter mat.